seat or on another safe place.
Okay. It just, but then just keep going.
Yeah.
See, I think I remember doing this at like the dining table while I was eating.
What's it on the dog?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's what, yeah, we're doing that.
But then you can bring it out and about. So with puppies, when we're going to sit on the dog or this, I'll love them and have a little chew toy.
Uh-huh.
And then you can go take a seat too. I'll just make sure it's not too far away. Relax. Take a load off.
So we have a lot of homework for this. Is this all this week?
Yeah.
Homework.
Yeah, but it's not as it's not as long. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like this, I might set them up for 5 minutes every day. And Yeah.
On the cat imprints. But remember, keep the distractions low at first. It's good. So I like to do this when they're a little bit sleepy.
Yeah.
That's less energy exercise. And then we'll do a puppy exam after this. You probably never did puppy exam with you because all of your puppies would have been too big to do puppy exam.
Is that what, like, the vet will do it?
Well, you started, it's so that they're used to being handled, but you hold them on your back in your lap until they stop squirming, and then you can start to get the grooming things in too, like the brushing and the...
Yeah, I've done that with Zoo's belly and hold them.
Yeah.
But you want to that helps when they're a little sleepy too.
Huh?
It helps when they're a little sleepy too.
Yes.
But I brush his teeth, so I love his mouth. I handle his paws.
The puppies that don't move too fast, I'll usually drop the leash too because I can always step on it if he goes. So this is a good time. So whenever I'm teaching them to chew on appropriate things, I just reintroduce the other thing to them. Chew on that, the leash.
They move themselves back up. He likes the blanket. He didn't like that leather thing.
So, and then if he tries to go, yes, he did. Yeah, well, just make sure whatever you train him on feels different from before because they use their paws to feel the difference once you get going. I'll let you jump up next time he you can move your chair real close.
He's got leash in his mouth.
Yeah. Just take it out and reintroduce the bone to him. Sometimes I was, we have a little older puppy here right now, Bandit. And Bandit was doing plays, and I had let him have this little soft watermelon toy. So he would purposely look at me, pick up the watermelon toy, drop it off the edge of the place. Which I was fine with as long as he stayed on it and waited for me to. But it was so funny, he was so like determined to get my attention. Yeah, you can pull the leash right out of his mouth. Good time for him to be learning. Just pop it down. We've got it here.
So we're doing a look at the nose, the sit,
or down,
and then back up to a sit.
Right. Okay. Place. Sit on the dog. Might as well be doing that this week too.
And so you sit on the leash until the dog. You know, sit down until they go down.
Right.
And then
I'll have you practice.
So.
Don't you worry. I'll probably do that after puppy exam.
Okay.
Yeah, just take it out of your mouth. Now, if you find he's very biting at the leash, you can always use like a not little leash, but I guess a not. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Like a cheap, chewy one.
A slip collar. That came once.
Oh, and they do tend to continue to practice it, just so you know. Then more than 5 minutes, I'll just wait for him to settle down. So take the leash out of his mouth, and then when he settles again, when you're gonna break him. If you don't release him, is what I mean. Say, okay. And on to puppy exam we go.
Good boy.
Yes.